गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज ए गोवर्धन, लेक्चरर इन केमिस्ट्री, जनरल सेक्शन, इंस्टीट्यूशन गवर्नमेंट पॉलिटेक्निक वड्डेपल्ली, डीलिंग सेमेस्टर इज सेकंड सेमेस्टर, सब्जेक्ट इंजीनियरिंग केमिस्ट्री एंड एनवायरमेंटल स्टडीज 2, सब्जेक्ट कोड 18:204A, टॉपिक करोसिन, ड्यूरेशन 50 मिनट्स, ओके, सब टॉपिक मेथड्स ऑफ प्रिवेंशन ऑफ करोसिन एंड आल्सो प्रोटेक्टिव कोटिंग्स। आई यूज योर टीचिंग एड्स, पीपीटीज एंड आल्सो एनिमेशंस। ओके, लेट अस स्टार्ट अवर क्लास। ओके, ऑन कंप्लीशन ऑफ अवर क्लास and completion of this period, we know about prevention methods of corrosion, protective coatings. What we are going to discuss preventive methods of corrosion and also protective coatings. Let us discuss one by one. Okay, so to know prevention methods, first we should know what is corrosion, what is the formula of rust, which metal undergoes corrosion in galvanic cell. Already we discussed in last classes, corrosion, it is a slow and gradual process by the action of environment. So that is called corrosion. So examples of corrosion already we discussed. So if you remember these points, you can understand very well prevention of corrosion. And also we know formula of rust, how the rusting takes place, how the chemical reaction takes place in rusting, already we discussed in last class. So Fe3O3 is formula of the rusting of iron. Fe2O3.XH2O means, if the moisture is present, the rusting also increases. This is already we discussed. So you should remember this point also. Next, which metal undergoes corrosion in galvanic cell? Already we discussed. Different metals are same metals, and also depend on oxygen concentration, cell formation takes place, galvanic cell formation takes place. So by the formation of the galvanic cells, corrosion or rusting takes place, especially rusting means in iron. Okay, so these are the basic points already we discussed. If you remember these points, you can understand how to prevent that corrosion, how the corrosion takes place. Already we know, if you know that chemical reactions, we can prevent by protecting from that reactions on surface of metals or different metals. Okay, so let us discuss one by one. Already we know that a lot of amount of iron is waste by the corrosion or rusting. So around 20% of economy we are losing by this wastage of the iron by the corrosion. So that's why corrosion causes holes formation, leakages, loss of property, danger of accidents, etc. Some poisonous gases releasing by the this rusting, and also holes formation from the dangerous gases, and also leakages from water pipelines, and also sometimes some breaking of the bridges, other danger accidents takes place, right? So all because of corrosion. Corrosion should be prevented by doing some other methods. So we should do prevention of corrosion by using suitable methods. That's why prevention of corrosion is very, very important. That's why we should discuss methods to prevention of corrosion, right? So how many methods are there? How to prevent that corrosion? Is there any natural methods? or artificial methods, we can discuss one by one. Okay, so first of all, the following methods are used to prevent the corrosion metals. First one, modification of the environment. We can modify the environment by using other materials. So that is also one example for the prevention of the corrosion. Suppose if moisture is there, if you remove moisture, or if their temperature is very high, we can decrease temperature. Like that, we can modify that modify environment which is surrounded that metal. Next, we can use coatings. We can use coatings, protect, those are called protective coatings. Protective coatings means by the coating we can protect that metal. Especially you should remember the metal which is going to take coating, that is called base metal. Okay, remember this point. The metal which is taking coating, or which we are ready to prevent that metal, which we are want to prevent that metal, that is called base metal. Okay, so by the coating on the base metal we can protect that metal. Those are that process are called protective coatings. Next to cathodic protection. So in this protection, first that metal which is going to corrosion, usually that is acting as a anode. So by doing other chemical reactions or other process, we can convert that anode into cathode. That is called cathodic protection, right? We should discuss one by one. Okay, see, first one, modification of environment. Okay, modification of environment. See here, deaeration. By adjustment of temperature, oxygen should be expelled. So this is called deaeration. By doing this process, we can prevent that metals from the corrosion. What is that means? So giving suitable optimum temperature and also oxygen levels. That is also important major point to prevent that metal from the corrosion. Next, deactivation. Deactivation means addition of hydrogen, sodium sulfate. It is deactivating from the corrosion of that metal. Okay, that is also one example of the modification of environment. Next, dehumidification. So already know, if humidity is present, corrosion takes place or rusting takes place. That's why we should remove humidity by adding silica gel or alumina gel. So these gels are very suitable examples for the observing that moisture which is surrounded by that metal. So dehumidification also very important to remove the humidity. You can use silica gel, alumina gel. Already you know, some objects which are selling by that sellers, they add that silica gel or alumina gel in that containers or other objects. So this is one example for the modification of environment. Next, alkaline addition, right? So addition of ammonia or sodium hydroxide also example for the modification of environment. Okay, so note down these methods. First, we should note down from the 5th page also. Note down these points. Okay, now next page also note down all important points. Modification of environment, in the deaeration, deactivation, dehumidification, alkaline addition. Note down these points. Okay, I hope you completed. Right, these are examples for the modification environment, and also other thing also to prevent from corrosion, that is by alloy formation. Already you know alloy means a homogeneous mixture of two or more metals is called alloy. So by the preparation of the alloy, we can prevent that metal from the corrosion. So here I have written a definition also. A homogeneous mixture of two or more metals with metallic properties called an alloy. The reactivity of metal is considerably reduced in the alloy, hence the corrosion of metal is reduced. Already you know why we are preparing alloys. So to prevent that, that means to change the properties of metals. In that properties, first one is very very important. The metal which is after prepare as a alloy, completely it is prevent from the corrosion, right? That is very very major important of the alloy preparation, right? So if prepare react, if prepare alloy, reactivity of that metals which we are used in that alloy completely considerable reduce that corrosion. Example, coinage metals, domestic utensils, you can prepare alloys. Why? Because in domestic purpose means in home needs we use in different purpose for washing and also the activities which are related to the water. Completely the utensils are they are not going to rust. Why? Because we are preparing, we are taking that utensils as a alloys. That's why there is no chance to rusting. Why? Because already we use it as a alloys. Okay, this is by alloy formation we are changing modification, we are changing that environment to prevent corrosion, right? So this is also very important activity. Note down this one, by alloy formation. By alloy formation we can protect the metal from the corrosion. Okay, see now protective coatings, right? Protecting coatings also very very important. So the following methods are used to prevent the corrosion in that protective coatings, right? So see here, corrosion is a surface phenomenon and can be prevented by applying protective coatings, right? So protective coatings are maybe two types: metallic coatings and also non-metallic coatings. So inorganic and organic, these both are non-metallic coatings, these are metallic coatings. So see here, a metal is coated with a suitable chemical material to prevent the corrosion. The following metals are used as protective coatings: metallic coatings, in non-metallic coatings, first one inorganic coatings and also organic coatings. These two are non-metallic coatings. Just wait. Right, so metallic and inorganic and organic coatings are non-metallic coating. Just wait, here I am writing non-metallic coatings. Right, these two are non-metallic coatings. So first one, yes, so this is the first one, this is metallic coatings, this is the second one, non-metallic coatings, Right? Now you can see, right? First one metallic coatings, second one non-metallic coatings. So this is the definition for the protective coatings with example. So note down. Right, so now we can discuss metallic coatings first. Second, after completion of metallic coatings, we can discuss non-metallic coatings, in that inorganic coatings and also organic coatings. Right, see here metallic coatings. So what is the meaning of metallic coating? So coating of one metal, right, coating of one metal over another metal is another metal in order to protect the metal from corrosion is called metallic coatings. What is the meaning of metallic coating? Coating of one metal over another metal in order to protect the metal from corrosion is called metallic coatings. Right? So based on type of metal used for coating, metallic coatings are divided into two types. Once again, I'm repeating. Based on type of metal used for coating, metallic coatings are divided into two types. So first one, anodic coating, second one, cathodic coating. Right, so see here, first we can know about anodic coating. What is the definition of anodic coating? In this coating, so first just wait, so note down this metallic coatings, anodic coating and cathodic. Okay, I hope you are following very well. Right, now we are going to discuss anodic coating. So in this coating, anodic coating means in this coating a more active metal is coated on a less active metal. So just now I said in anodic coating, so what happened? In anodic coating, in this coating a more reactive metal is coated on a less active metal, right? So simply we can say base metal coated by active metal. Active metal, so that is anodic coating. See here, anodic coating means in this coating a more active metal is coated on less active metal. So now this less active metal is called base metal. Okay, example, zinc coating on iron. So that means it is called galvanization. Already you know galvanization. Iron is coated by zinc. Now zinc going to corrosion to protect that iron from the corrosion. So that's why it is called anodic coating. Why? Because now coated metal acting as a anode to prevent that base metal from the corrosion. So this is called anodic coating. Example, galvanization. Right? So another example, coating of zinc on aluminium or iron. Iron means galvanization, and also coating of zinc on aluminium also other example for anodic coating. Next to cathodic coating. Cathodic coating means in this coating a less reactive metal is coated on a more reactive metal. Means here more reactive metal is a base metal. So now I can type that base metal. Right, Now a more active metal. Now this is a base metal. We can say this is base metal. Base metal. Right, this base metal coated by less active metal. Example, coating of tin on copper or iron. Right, tin coating on iron or copper, it is example for the cathodic coating. See, here in cathodic coating we are coating less reactive metal on more reactive metal. Now coated metal, it is resistance to corrosion to protect the base metal. So that's why it is called cathodic protection, right? A cathodic coating. Okay, so these are the metallic coatings, examples anodic coating and cathodic coating. Now another important topic is differences between the anodic coatings and also cathodic coatings. These are also very very important, right? Let us discuss one by one. Left side I have taken anodic coating, right side cathodic coating. First of all, note down these points: anodic coating, cathodic coating, with examples. Note down these points. Right, so already you know anodic coating and cathodic coating. Now see differences between the anodic coatings and also cathodic coatings. Left side anodic coating, right side cathodic coating. So first we can write first point as a definition, right? See, here in anodic coating, base metal, right, base metal coated by more active metal, so that is called anodic coating. In cathodic coating, base metal coated by less active metal, that is called cathodic coating. That's why I have written here, it is produced by covering base metal with an anodic metal. It is produced by covering base metal with a noble metal. Noble metal means less reactive metal. Here anodic metal means more active metal. Already you know electrochemical series, in that top metals which are above on the series, those are more active metals. The metals which are bottom of that series, those are less reactive metals. So this is the first point. Okay, next to second point, electro potential of coated metal is lower than that of base metal. It is very very important. SRP of coated metal is lower than that of base metal, right? The metal which is coated to base metal, the SRP of that metal is very less than the base metal. Here it is anodic coating. In cathodic coating, SRP of coated metal is more than that of the base metal. So this is the second point, right? This is SRP comparison. SRP means standard reduction potential. Note down these two points. Okay, let us discuss the next points. Already we completed 2 points. Next, see in 12th page, in 12th slide, third point, it protects the underlying base metal sacrificially, right? So see here, it protects the underlying base metal sacrificially. So what is that meaning? The metal which is coated to base metal, that is more active metal, the more active metal undergoing corrosion to protect the base metal. That's why it is called sacrificial anode method, right? Anodic coating is called sacrificial anode method. Why? Because the more metal which is coated to base metal, that is going to corrosion to protect the base metal. That's why it is called sacrificial anode method. So see here in cathodic coating third point, the coated metal prevents base metal from corrosion by showing resistance to corrosion. So what did that mean? Already we coated base metal with a less active metal. So it is a less active metal means it is very resistant to corrosion. So showing resistance to corrosion, that's why obviously base metal protected from the corrosion, right? So that's why this is cathodic protection. So third point, here left side cathodic coating, anodic coating, right side anodic cathodic coating. So after that, fourth point, the base metal is not corroded even when pores develop in the surface coating, right? So next point, when pores or cracks are formed in coated metal, no corrosion takes place in base metal, right? Example, see here. First understanding is very important. So in anodic coating, if the coated metal takes place any rusting means what is called pores or other cracks formation takes place, there is no corrosion in base metal. But in cathodic coating, the base metal corrodes when cracks or pores develop on the coating. Why? Because the coated metal is less reactive metal. So if the holes are cracks formation on the coated metal, base metal, obviously corrosion takes place. So next, for anodic coating example, galvanization. Galvanization means zinc coated on iron. So for cathodic coating example, tinning. Tinning means tin coating on iron. See here, left side, zinc is more active than iron. Now zinc going to corrosion to protect the iron. That's why it is called sacrificial anode method. Right side, tin is less reactive than iron. Now iron is a base metal. Tin coated on iron. So now tin, it is very less reactive metal. That's why it is preventing corrosion, showing resistance to corrosion. That's why this base metal protecting. So it is example for the cathodic coating. So note down this third, fourth and also examples for anodic coating and cathodic coating. Okay, completed. So these are anodic coatings and cathodic coatings examples. Next, inorganic coatings. Okay, see here, inorganic coatings. Already know organic and inorganic coatings are examples for the non-metallic coatings, right? So in a non-metallic coatings are two types. In that first one, inorganic coating. Second one, organic coating. See here, in organic coatings, first one, phosphate coatings. So phosphate coatings, it can be produced by dipping the base metal in the solution formed from phosphoric acid and also phosphate of zinc and iron or manganese and iron. It is useful to for metals like iron, steel, zinc, etc. Right? Here I have written only zinc and manganese phosphate supplied on iron steel. How they apply? Simply, base metal dipped into that solution which is made by phosphate of zinc or iron or manganese and iron. It is especially used for metals like iron and also steel, zinc, etc. This is called phosphate coating, right? So phosphate coating means base metal dipped into phosphate solution. Next, chromate coatings. Chromate coatings means it can be produced by dipping the base metal in a bath of acidic potassium chromate and also then neutral chromate solution. So it is useful for metals like zinc, aluminium, magnesium and also cadmium. Here I noted one point. Potassium chromate is used on zinc. How they use? So it can be produced by the dipping the base metal in a bath of acidic potassium chromate and also then neutral chromate solution. Okay, so that is called chromate coating. Right, potassium chromate usually means that zinc metal or other metals, aluminium metal and also magnesium, cadmium, dipped into first of all acidic potassium chromate, after that neutral chromate solution. We can prepare that metal. So that is called chromate coating. This chromate coating and also phosphate coatings prevent that metals from the corrosion. Next, oxide coatings. See here, it increases corrosion resistance power. So how they coat that? So that metals converting oxides. So oxide layer is very strong. That's why the metal after converting as the oxides, they are preventing from the corrosion. For other some more explanation for the oxide coatings. So the oxide coating is obtained by the chemical reactions of base metal with the alkaline oxidizing solutions. Right? That means base solutions, alkaline oxidizing solutions they are called. These are a base primer coating for oils, greases and waxes. These are the inorganic coatings. So note down these points. Okay, already this completed. Note down this inorganic coatings. Okay, these are inorganic coatings. Next, organic coatings. We have so many organic coatings. The important organic coatings are वार्निशेस, पेंट्स, लैक्वेयर्स, एनामेल्स, एमल्शंस एटसेट्रा वी कैन यूज एज ए ऑर्गेनिक कोटिंग्स. सो इन ऑर्गेनिक कोटिंग्स वी यूजिंग ऑर्गेनिक मटेरियल टू प्रिवेंट द मेटल फ्रॉम द करोजन. सी फर्स्ट वन वार्निशेस. सो हाउ इट इज वर्क्स. इट विल फॉर्म हार्ड प्रोटेक्टिव फिल्म ऑन आयरन कंट्रोल्स करोजन. राइट, इफ यू अप्लाई वार्निश ऑन द मेटल, दिस वार्निश विल फॉर्म हार्ड प्रोटेक्टिव फिल्म ऑन आयरन कंट्रोल्स करोजन एंड ऑल्सो इट्स इट इज गिव शाइनिंग, दैट मीन्स डेकोरेटिव सर्फेस ऑन द मेटल ऑल्सो. सो दिस इज एग्जाम्पल फॉर द वार्निशेस, इट इज एग्जाम्पल फॉर ऑर्गेनिक कोटिंग. नेक्स्ट पेंट्स. ओके, पेंट्स दीज आर विस्कस सस्पेंशन रेजिन्स कंट्रोल्स करोजन. लाइक ए वार्निशेस वी कैन अप्लाई पेंट्स ऑन द पेंट्स ऑन द मेटल्स ऑल्सो. राइट, दिस पेंट्स दे फॉर्म विस्कस सस्पेंशन रेजिन्स, दोज आर रेडी टू कंट्रोल द करोजन. सो दैट्स वाई दिस मेटल्स प्रिवेंट फ्रॉम द करोजन बाय यूजिंग पेंट्स. नेक्स्ट लैक्वेयर्स, दीज आर थिक टफ ग्लासी लेयर फॉर्मड ऑन आयरन कंट्रोल्स करोजन. राइट, इफ यू अप्लाई लैक्वेयर्स ऑन द आयरन, सो दीज आर थिक. ओके, दीज आर थिक टफ ग्लासी लेयर फॉर्मेशन ऑन आयरन कंट्रोल्स करोजन. सो दीज आर एग्जाम्पल्स फॉर द लैक्वेयर्स, दैट मीन्स दे गिव सम ग्लॉसी लेयर फॉर्मेशन एंड ऑल्सो प्रिवेंट्स करोजन. नेक्स्ट एनामेल्स. सो एनामेल्स ऑल्सो एग्जाम्पल फॉर द ऑर्गेनिक कोटिंग्स. एनामेल्स मीन्स पिगमेंटेड वार्निशेज प्रोड्यूस्ड हार्ड फिल्म रेजिस्टेंस टू करोजन. सो इट इज गिविंग डेकोरेटिव कलरफुल सर्फेस फॉर द मेटल एंड ऑल्सो प्रिवेंट फ्रॉम द करोजन. सो दैट्स वाई एनामेल्स मीन्स पिगमेंटेड वार्निशेस प्रोड्यूस्ड हार्ड फिल्म रेजिस्ट फ्रॉम द करोजन. राइट, सो दिस इज एनामेल्स. नेक्स्ट एमल्शंस. ओके, हाउ दे वर्क एमल्शंस. डिस्पर्शन ऑफ सिंथेटिक रेजिन्स एंड ऑयल्स रिड्यूस करोजन. इफ यू अप्लाई एमल्शन ऑन द मेटल, सो दे आर फॉर्मिंग सिंथेटिक रेजिन्स एंड ऑल्सो ऑयल्स. सो इफ दे फॉर्म सिंथेटिक रेजिन्स एंड ऑयल्स, दे रिड्यूस मेटल फ्रॉम द करोजन. सो दोज आर एग्जाम्पल्स फॉर द एमल्शंस. Some other organic coatings are there. Those are very very familiar example. Plastics. Okay, here I have not noted here, so I'll try to write here. So next to plastics also examples for organic coatings. In plastics we can use polythene and also PVC. Right, plastics example PVC and also PVC polythene. Right, PVC and polythene, they can prevent the corrosion. So in plastics also example for the organic coatings. Right, so like this plastics are effective protection coatings under severe conditions like a sea water and also industrial atmosphere. Right, some also we can use chemicals. Example bisphenol also we can use for the protecting from the corrosion. Right, so these are the organic coatings. Note down all points. Varnishes, paints, lacquers, enamels, emulsions, plastics and also some chemicals like bisphenol. These are the examples for the organic coatings. Okay, summary. Up to now we have discussed about protective coatings, in that metallic coatings, non-metallic coatings, right? Protective coatings means anodic coatings and cathodic coatings, right? That means in protective coatings, example, metallic coatings, anodic coatings and cathodic coatings. In non-metallic, organic coatings and also inorganic coatings. Right. In inorganic coatings, we discussed phosphate coating, chromate coating, and also next one, oxide layer formation. In organic coatings, we used varnishes, lacquers, and also paints, pigments, other plastics. We used as a coated materials. So up to now, we discussed these things. I hope you understand very well. Now see here some frequently asked questions. What are the difference between the anodic coatings and also cathodic coatings? Next, state the different organic materials used as protective coatings. These are the frequently asked questions. Next, see here, I have given some quiz questions. First one, metal with higher oxidation potential used as A. anodic coating, B. cathodic coating, C. alloying, D. none. So which is the correct option? Choose all of you. Which is the correct answer? Right, metal with higher oxidation potential used, which is the correct answer? It is used as a anodic coating. It is called anodic coating. For the first question, answer is anodic coating. Okay, right. For second question, metal below iron is chemical series like silver, copper are coated on iron as. Once again, I'm repeating. Metal below iron in chemical series like silver, copper, gold are coated on iron as A. anodic coating, B. cathodic coating, C. alloying, D. oxide layer formation. So this type, which is the correct answer? See here, anodic coating for less active metal, that means base metal coated by more active metal. Alloying, so alloy formation, oxide layer, other thing. So which is the correct answer? Cathodic coating is the correct answer for metals below iron and chemical series like silver, gold, and also copper are coated on iron. So answer is cathode coating. Next, third one, right, see here, third question, when organic paints varnishes are used, A. reduces corrosion by oxidation, increase corrosion of metal, stop corrosion by film formation, D. none of the above. Which is the correct answer? See here. When organic paints or varnishes used for corrosion, which is the correct answer? They stop corrosion by film formation, which is the correct answer? So the paints and varnishes, they stop corrosion by film formation. Okay, so next question, see here, fourth question, corrosion is controlled by A. rising purity of metal, B, reducing strain, C, metallic coatings, D, all of the above. Which is the correct answer? See, fourth one, corrosion is controlled by. So which is the correct answer? Which is the correct answer? All the above means corrosion controlled by rising purity of metal, reducing strain, and also metallic coating. So fourth one is the correct answer, right? So up to now we discussed already. I have given summary also. Coatings in that metallic coatings and also non-metallic coatings. In metallic coatings, anodic coatings and also cathodic coatings, right? Next class we are going to discuss some cathodic protection which is used to prevent the corrosion. So in cathodic protection, first of all, sacrificial anode method. Second one, impressed voltage method. We can discuss in next class. Okay, thank you.